أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نويت الأربعين نويت الاعتكاف نويت الخلوة نويت العزلة نويت الرياضة نويت السلوك لله تعالى العظيم في هذا المسجد أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول وأولي الأمر منكم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته A new day A new page Every day is a page in our life. And we don't want to lose these special moments in a house of Allah's houses. So we try as much as we can to sit together as Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam mentioned in one hadith that Imam has mentioned it yesterday. An Anas ibn Malik, Sayyidina Anas related that Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, إِذَا مَرَرْتُمْ بِرِيَاضِ الْجَنَّةِ فَارْتَعُوا And that's why we don't want to lose the meaning of that hadith but we have to fulfill it as much as we can. And Prophet said that if you pass إِذَا مَرَرْتُمْ بِرِيَاضِ الْجَنَّةِ فَارْتَعُوا If you pass through a group of people sitting, like this way, it's considered a rawda from paradise. Is from Riyadul Jannah, means a quarter is a place in Jannah that people can have their own paradises, different paradises. So he said that this sitting in a masjid or in a house or in a hall, making zikrullah, mentioning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, remembering him and remembering his prophet, and sitting and listening to each other, that is a riyadul jannah, like everyone killing himself to reach Madinatul Munawwara, to visit Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to pray in Rawdatul Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. الروضة المشرفة. Why we go there? We pray there. Why? Because it is a piece of paradise. That piece of paradise, why became piece of paradise? Is Allah has brought a stone from paradise, put it there, like Al-Hajar al-As'ad? No. But it became Rawda min Riyad al-Jannah, that piece where everyone goes and pray 2 rak'ahs or 10 rak'ahs or whatever, because the barakah of the foot of the feet of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when they touch that place, it turned it into a Rawda from paradise. As that happened, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam want his ummah to have to inherit from that secret and to be dressed from that secret of be in dunya but they are in paradise. So this meeting, these meetings like that, whatever had happened during the day, during the year, during the month, as masajid, people are sitting together and remembering and making zikrullah, it become a place, a rawda of Riyadul Jannah. And when you are in rawda in Riyadul Jannah, means it is a amina mutma'inna, is this peaceful and safety from hellfire. So if you sit one time in one of Riyadul Jannah, you think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to take you, put you in hellfire after he dressed you from the manifestation and the beautiful paradise in Jannah? No way. That's why Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said fartau, yani sit and graze, means sit and eat, and from this zikr, eat from the manifestation of these beautiful names and attributes that you are reciting Allah with them. You are remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with these words. قَالُوا وَمَا رِيَادُ الْجَنَّةِ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ What are these رِيَادُ الْجَنَّةِ that we have to run to them? He said, حِلَقُ الذِّكْرِ O Muslims, حِلَقُ الذِّكْرِ is mentioned in many ahadith. Dhikrullah is mentioned in many ahadith. Anything that relates to heaven is paradise. Anything is related to heaven is zikrullah. If you read Quran, is zikrullah. If you read hadith, is zikrullah. If you make salawat, zikrullah. If you make recitation of beautiful names and attributes, is zikrullah. If you sit together, even you don't say anything, you sit two people together in a masjid and not saying anything, but they are sitting in the masjid, is zikrullah. Their breath will become zikrullah. They asked Imam Suyuti, and I will say what he said. You know Imam Jalaluddin Suyuti, who make Tafsir al-Jalalain, the first half, he did it. The other half, someone else did it, but also called Jalal. So that's why it is called Al-Jalalain, the two ulama. So Imam As-Suyuti wrote many books, and in his tafsir and in his book, they asked him, it is mentioned in his book, Kashful Qina'. Kashful Qina' unveiled the mask. He has a book. سئل جلال الدين السيوطي رحمه الله تعالى عن عقد حلق الذكر والجهر في المساجد about association, ذكر association like this association and raise your voices جهر to raise loud when you are doing ذكر in مساجد ورفع الصوت بالتهليل and when you say سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله الله أكبر you raise your voice is it accepted or not it is makruh or no makruh means disliked or no and he said he's a big alim بأنه لا كراهة في شيء من ذلك there is no dislike in anything like that But it is liked. It is not disliked, but it is accepted and liked by Allah and His Prophet. So no one can say Zikrullah is not allowed. One of the big ulama whom they study today everywhere around the world, even in the areas, in countries they have their own mazhab, they still study Jalaluddin al-Suyuti and study his books and they know he is a big alim. He said, Allah likes these associations, these sittings, these meetings that they are doing zikrullah. So that is clear for us, that's clear for the audience if they are listening and hearing. وَقَدْ وَرَدَتْ he say, وَقَدْ وَرَدَتْ أَحَادِيثٌ كَثِيرَ تَقْتَدِ اسْتِحْبَابَ الْجَهْرِ بِالذِّكْرِ Too many ahadith that be mentioned about the zikr, loud zikr. And we will quote one hadith at the end. وَبَيْنَ الْأَحَادِيثِ الْوَارِدَ بِاسْتِحْبَابِ الْجَهْرِ بِكِرَاءَةِ الْقُرْآنِ And also one of them that it is liked to raise your voice is when you are reading Holy Quran. So when you are reading Holy Quran, You mention in Holy Quran many times, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, Wa la ilaha illallah, Wallahu Akbar. One of these words is being mentioned, or Allah is being mentioned, or Muhammad is being mentioned, or angels are being mentioned, or Allah's beautiful names are being mentioned. Wa lillahi al-asma'ul husna fad'uhu biha. It is mentioned and Allah is asking, call me on it, call me with it, ask me with it, with these beautiful names and attributes. So all these, as ever mentioned in Holy Quran, you can make them your word daily, and you can take some of these words, beautiful names and attributes, or verses, and you recite them in Jama'ah, and it is said that it is liked to have to raise your voice in recitation of Holy Quran or part from Holy Quran. وَقَدْ جَمَعَ الْإِمَامُ النَّوَوِي أَيْضًا Imam Nawawi, in his book Al-Azkar, he said that وَالْجَهْرْ أَفْضَلْ مِنْ فِي غَيْرِ ذَلِكَ Al-Jahr, to have a loud voice in Zikrullah, is accepted in some areas more than the khafi, the hidden zikr is recommended. So both ulama, we are quoting them in order to say that zikrullah is accepted wherever, however you like to mention it. You can mention in any way you like. You can mention, as we said yesterday, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. It's a zikr or not? It is mentioned in the Holy Quran or not? It is. So if we say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, what we got now? An Jabir ibn Abdullah called. عن ابن مسعود, one of the biggest Sahabi, he said, إنه من أراد أن ينجيه الله من الزبانية التسعة عشر فليقرأ بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Whom he wants that Allah will save him from زبانية جهنم, the angels that control جهنم, 19 of them, he has to read بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ليجعل الله تعالى بكل حرف منها جنة من كل واحد. Allah will make from every letter of Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim a safety for that person from these angels of Zabaniya Jahannam. They will take him out. If he was judged for punishment, these angels will take him out. Because he recited Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. And Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is the number of the letters is the same number of these angels, 19. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is 19 letters, is the number of the 19 angels of hellfire. So every letter represents one angel. So when you recite calling Allah, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, you are saying, Ya Rabbi, save us. Let your angels of hellfire to save us. We are mentioning, they are representing one letter of your name in Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will save these people from hellfire. If you look, everything in Holy Quran and everything in the Hadith, everything has a meaning and has a sign. There is three places and that everyone can see without learning how this 19 formula came, the number 19. But everyone can see the relationship between calling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim or calling Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam through certain names that Prophet likes. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim equal 19 angels in numbers, I'm speaking, not in barakah or in numbers, equal the 19 angels of hellfire, equal the 19 letters that consist Ahlul Aba. You know Ahlul Aba? The family of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that Prophet covered them with his jubba, and he said, "These are my family. Don't hurt them." Ahlul Aba is Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Muhammad, his daughter Fatima, Sayyidina Ali, Sayyidina al-Hassan, Sayyidina al-Hussein. If you count the letters of Muhammad, Fatima, Ali, Hassan, Hussein, is 19. 19 letters. Every letter of their names represent every letter of Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So if you say Ya Muhammad, as if you are counting how many letters? 4 letters. Fatima, 5 letters. If you add them, it will become 19. You add Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, 19. The angels of hellfire, 19. So the barakah of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will save you from angels of hellfire. Barakah of Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim save you from hellfire. So zikr is important in Islam, is important in spirituality, is important for everyone to save himself from hellfire. Say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim as much as you say. That's why we have been ordered for our teachers to recite every day 100 times Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. That's zikrullah. The other zikr, qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this hadith is from Bukhari, because sometimes viewers on the internet might say, oh, this hadith from where, this hadith from, we want only Bukhari. Okay, we will quote Imam Bukhari. Why, is only Imam Bukhari is what Prophet said? Prophet used to speak with the young, used to speak with the elder, used to speak with the adult, he speak with everyone, and recite one hadith, might be the other one, they never heard it. Not all Sahaba heard the hadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal memorized 300,000 hadiths between all categories of hadith. They might ask, how many categories of hadith? Huh? Over 50. It's not only Sahih, Hassan, Da'if, Maqbool, but there is 50 different, over 50 different kind of ahadith. The hadith you never heard, might be someone else, Sahaba heard it. So, never mind, we go as they like, and this is a hadith from Bukhari. He said, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Inna lillahi malaikatan yatufuna fi turuq." There, Allah has angels that they are roaming in the at-turuq, in the streets. But Imam here will ask him now. And they are like your telephones, roam you with you. Allah doesn't have heavenly technology. Kun fayakun. Angels, Allah ordered them, look, search for hilakul zikr, like this association meetings. That's why angels are filling the place. You are not seeing them. I'm not seeing them. You are not seeing them. Imam is seeing them. So it's enough. Might be the viewers are seeing them. Who knows? There are many people can see, many people cannot see. But he said, "Yatufuna fi turuq." A turuq has two meanings. Turuq is the street. And turuq, tariq. Tariq is a plural, is turuq. Or turuqat. But also turuq means Sufi orders. A turuq, different tariqa. What is the plural of a tariqa? Turuq. So means they are following and moving and roaming and coming to the people of Ahlul Tasawwuf first. because they are the real people of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, that they are loving Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, making zikr and accepting everything, showing the greatness of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Pakistan. That's nice. Now we are in Pakistan. So these angels are happy with Ahlul Turuq, with the people of Tariqah. وَأَنْ لَوْ اسْتَقَامُوا عَلَى الطَّرِيقَةِ لَأَسْقَيْنَاهُمْ مَاءً غَدَقًا. If they keep on the tariqah, means on the right path, in Siratul Mustaqim, also it means if they keep on their tariqah, that means their guidance of their shuyukh in different turuq. There are many turuq, many shuyukh, and everyone has his own understanding and way that he feels Allah has dressed him with it. So we cannot deny that. They are Chisti tariqah, they are Qadiri tariqah, they are Naqshbandi tariqah, there are Kabrawi tariqah, there are Shaziri tariqah, there are Muridiya tariqah, 41 tariqah. The main. So we cannot deny anyone. All of them, they are guiding you to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the door of Prophet. يَلْتَمِسُونَ أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ. They are searching, where are people remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? They found them here. Today, we are here. Might be there are other people in somewhere else. They will find them. They will find everyone. Even one person in the mountain, they will find him. No way someone on the mountain is making zikrullah, angels will be there. Hadith al-Nabi, Bukhari. فَإِذَا وَجَدُوا قَوْمًا يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى تَنَادَوْا هَلُمُّوا إِلَى حَاجَتِكُمْ. If they find a group of people remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they say, come quickly. That's the place where we have to come, to sit with them. They come and sit. Now they are sitting. We are not seeing, but the hadith is saying. Hadith is saying and seeing. We are not seeing, but we are being dressed with their presence. Of course, they are here. La shakka wa la shubha, no doubts. فَيَحُفُّونَهُمْ بِأَجْنِحَتِهِمْ إِلَى سَمَاءِ الدُّنْيَا. Allahu Akbar. Means they rub their wings up. If we can say up, because there is no up, no down in heavens. They all the way to sama' al-dunya, they will circle, encompass you in circles until they reach sama' al-dunya. All through that group of people are within that circle of angels. Count how many angels. From here until sama' al-dunya, it's not the beyond the universe. Universe, how many galaxies, Imam? Our galaxy is one galaxy. It has 80 billion stars. They found there is 6,000 galaxies, bigger than our galaxy. And every galaxy is more than 80 billion stars. Not million, billions. This is still not the whole universe. We don't want to go into physics now, but they go above that, where there is nothing except heavens, They go there, they are from there all the way encompassing us here, and their zikr will be written for us. قَالَ فَيَسْأَلُهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ Allah will ask them, oh my angels, what my servants are saying? مَا يَقُولُ عِبَادِي What they are saying? فَيَقُولُونَ And they answer, يَا رَبَّنَا They are يُسَبِّحُونَكَ وَيُكَبِّرُونَكَ وَيُحَمِّدُونَكَ وَيُمَجِّدُونَكَ They are glorifying you, praising you, saying your greatness, Allahu Akbar, and tahleel for you, saying Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah, whatever, and subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. Fayaqul, Allah, I'll ask his angel. Allah doesn't know, he knows, but Prophet wants to relate that holy hadith. Fayaqul, har ra'awni, did they see me? Qal, fayaqulun, they say no, they didn't see you, ya Rabbana, oh Allah, they didn't see you. قال فيقول كيف لو رأوني how is it if they will see me what they would have done without seeing me they are making tasbih and making zikr sitting like that if they see me what they will do and they answered لو رأوك كانوا أشد لك عبادة وأشد تحميدا وأكثر تسبيحا if they see you they will make more worshipness. Worshipness that has no limits. They will be in sajda day and night, making tahmid, takbir, tahleel, tamjid. قال فيقولون فما يسألوني Okay, I know they will do more ibadah, but what they are asking me, what they want from me, Allah is asking angels. قال يسألونك الجنة What they want? They are asking you paradise. قال فكيف لو رأوها No. وهل رأوها Did they see paradise? If they are asking for paradise, did they see the paradise? They say no, they didn't see the paradise. He said, if they see the paradise, what they are going to do? يقولون لو أنهم رأوها كانوا أشد عليها حرصا وأشد لها طلبا. If they will see it, they will be more asking for it and more requesting it. And in their whole life, their zikr will be Jannah, 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 Ya Rabbi, Jannah, Ya Rabbi, Jannah. They will never stop. Allahu Akbar. That's the meaning. قال فبما يتعوذون in what they seek refuge يقولون يتعوذون من النار they seek refuge in you from hellfire فيقول هل رأوها did they see the hellfire they are asking refuge from it قال يقولون لا والله ما رأوها no they didn't see it and Allah say What will happen if they will see it? What will happen to them if they see it? يقولون they answer لو رأوها كانوا أشد منها فرارا وأشد لها مخافة. If they see it, they would run away. ففروا إلى الله. They run to you, Ya Allah. They run away from fire. They run away from hellfire. They run away from its flames. They run away from its heat. They will run away for you, Ya Allah. That's why they are asking refuge in you from hellfire. فَيَقُولُ فَأُشْهِدُكُمْ I make you witness. Oh my angels, I make you witness. أُشْهِدُكُمْ means seeing and hearing. I make you witness أَنِّي قَدْ غَفَرْتُ لَهُمْ that you are my witness that I have forgiven them. Say Allah.
Allah.
Say La ilaha illallah.
La ilaha illallah.
Allahumma ajirna min al-nar. We said it or not? You are saying it 7 times a day in the morning? Allah, it's recommended. Allahumma ajirna min al-nar, Allahumma ajirna min al-nar. Seeking refuge in Allah from hellfire. Asking Allah paradise. Asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to see him in the akhirah. Asking Allah everything. Allah say in the end, look, you are my witness. I have forgiven them. Go. Go be happy. Go celebrate your happiness by making maulid for Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is our celebration for happiness. Not to go to entertain ourselves here and there. No, our happiness is in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Our life is in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Our love to children, our children and family is in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Everything for us is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam because he takes us to the door of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَيَقُولْ مَلَكٌ مِّنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. One of the angels will say, فِيهِمْ فُلَانٌ لَيْسَ مِنْهُمْ وَإِنَّمَا جَاءَ لِحَاجَةٍ. Means there is one between them, he is not from them. He came only to see Ayyub, or to see Yaqub, or to see Musa, or to see anyone. He didn't make zikr, he didn't make anything. He coming from the door, sitting, waiting till they finish, that he wants to speak with someone. Qala, Allah will say, humul julasa la yashqa bihum jalisuhum. They are, humul julasa, means those are the ones that they are sitting for Allah's love, no. Anyone who comes with them and sit for a moment, Allah will give him free of hellfire. Because he will not pull that friend from there, from between them. He will keep that friend with that friend. So even he comes for something that he needs, he becomes... Because he is a friend of this association, of this circle of zikr, I will forgive him. Rawahu al-Bukhari. O viewers, this is shay'un qaleel, very little of what treasures of Islam you can find. Read about this greatness of zikrullah, and zikrullah has no limits of reward. No one can understand how much Allah will reward those who are sitting in zikr, al-zakirin Allah wa-dhakirat. Ladies or men, that they are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the great scholar Ali al-Khawas said, ينبغي للمريد أن يذكر بقوة تامة مع الجهر. He said, it is important for the student or the one who is sitting in the zikr association that he will make zikr with complete force. Like when you say, some people in between us here, when you mention something and they like it, what they say? Takbir. But what they say, how they say takbir? They don't say takbir. Takbir. They say takbir!
Allahu Akbar!
This how you have to say, Allah!
Allah!
Allah likes his servants to call him with love. Not takbir. That will not work. You'll be rewarded, but you have to show that you have eagerness for love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and love of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he said that, why? وَيَنْبَغِي لَهُ أَنْ يَذْكُرْ مَعَ الْجَمَاعَةِ. And he has to be with a group of people. Why he said with a group of people? Why not by himself alone? It can be. You can do it by yourself. You don't need a group of people. But he insisted, Ali al-Khawwas, that you have to have group of people. Because he said, and he has very good, Yadullahi ma'al jama'ah. Allah's hand means Allah's power, Allah's greatness will descend on the jama'ah. When you are in jama'ah, that's why it's preferable to pray your prayers with jama'ah. It is also preferable to make you zikr with jama'ah. Because in jama'ah, your fa'al hujub, veils will be lifted up. By yourself, you might not have that eagerness in recitation strongly. So this hujub will not, by yourself, will not be raised quickly. But with jama'ah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take it away. And Allah has described our hearts is like stones, big stones. Can you break a stone by a hammer? No. What you need a bulldozer. Jama'ah is bulldozer. When someone by himself say Allah is a tractor, that person. A little bit cutting grass. But with a jama'ah, say Allah, and everyone say Allah!
Allah!
A bulldozer. Paving the way. He said, group of people can, with hammer, can break the stone. But one person with hammer, even the same hammer, cannot break the stone. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us to break our heart stone. Because he broke it for Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam. When he said, because Sayyidina Musa is Kalimullah, he said, Rabbi arini anzur ilayk. Kalimullah, he didn't feel any more boundaries when you
No reverence.
So you cross the border. You don't know that you are crossing the border. So Sayyidina Musa crossed the border. He said, Ya Rabbi, I want to see you. And Allah said, what you want to see? Cannot see me. How you are going to see me on earth? Allah cannot be contained. Everything is contained by Allah's power. But Allah has no place. You cannot say this or that or that or that. He up, he's down, he's this, he's that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no time, no place, nowhere. No ayn. Ayn. No anywhere. You cannot say. So he said, let me see you. He said, okay, I love you. I will tell you what you need to do. انظر إلى الجبل فإن استقر مكانه فسوف تراني. Look at the mountain. I will manifest myself, my beautiful names and attributes. If the mountain stays in its place, you can see me. وفلما تجلى ربه للجبل جعله دكا. When Allah manifests His beautiful names and attributes, He shattered the mountain, become like dust. فخر موسى Saika. He fell down, fainted. What was the mountain? The mountain is the ego of Sayyidina Sulaiman, Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tajalla, he manifested his beautiful names and attributes on the heart of Sayyidina Musa, that great mountain that just we said now, you have to hammer the mountain to break it. Allah broke the mountain of Sayyidina Musa completely. He felt fainted. Muhyiddin ibn Arabi said that is the mountain of egoism that was broken. Fakharra Musa sa'iqa, he fainted because now he's in coma. No more power. Allah destroyed his power. Allah made him not knowing anything. Until he repented, he stood up when Allah wanted him to come back. So mountains, our ego are so huge, so big, so arrogant. We are proud of ourselves. We have to be soft. We have to be humble. That's what we need. To be humble, come to this such association, such sitting. Remember Allah, remember His Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah will remember you in a place better than your place. Allah will be ana jalisu man dhakarani. I am with the one that who remember me and mention me. Mention him daily. You will find him whenever you need. Wa min Allahi tawfiq bi hurmati al-Fatiha.